Today I really want to make a video for the Roaring Twenties. Some emos really want to bring back the old school emos from the 2000s. Because it's a little, not popular anymore. But they want to bring back a lot more emos and scenes from the 2000s back to the 2020, and it's called the Roaring Twenties, and I really like the idea, so I'm going to give 15 tips for how to be an old school emo in 2020. The most important thing to be an emo is listen to emotional hardcore, because the whole subculture is based on the music. Do your hair like this to big and fluffy. Boys can do that, but girls too, because it's really old school and really emo. And for girls, you need a bow in your hair, because that looks really emo too, and you just recognize immediately your emo. You need your nails polished black. Emos and scenes from the past did bright things on their hands and took selfies with it. They also wrote things on paper and cut it out and took selfies with it too. Always use eyeliner. Emos and scenes from the past did write things and draw things on their shoes. I have seen that a lot, and I did that too. So write things on your shoes. Be straight edge. That means you don't smoke, you don't drink, and you don't use any drugs. A lot of emos and scenes from the past were straight edge. Scenes and emos from the past used to be vegetarian as well. But when you're not, I think you still have to be very respectful to animals, and I'm not vegetarian as well, but just be respectful with animals. Make contact with other emos and scenes on social media. MySpace doesn't exist anymore, but you can use Facebook and Instagram. Just make contact with other emos. You need to know RAR XD means I love you in dinosaur. A lot of scenes and emos used to say that. You need to wear 2 pair of laces on your shoes. This can be in black and white, or pink and green, or pink and black. I heard this from someone who was in the emo subculture since 2008. So I think this is true, and so wear 2 different laces. Your true love is music. Music is your therapy and saves your life. So when you're sad or anything, just listen to emotional hardcore, because it will save your life. I think as an emo, it's really important to talk about your feelings and don't hide it. Just don't lie about how you feel, and just talk about it, and don't lie when you feel sad. Just say you're sad and talk about it. So these were all my 15 tips. I hope this will help you to be an emo in 2020 and be part of the Roaring Twenties. So I hope you like it, and bye.